it's a heart-wrenching issue because we hear about gun violence every day, every day. There's a many-faceted problem. I mean, one, we have to have adults in the schools, not just the teachers, because the teachers are teaching. We have to have adults in the school whose job it is to reach out to children, to know the children, to identify the children who may be in crisis, who may be prone to such a violent outburst. We have to have good, solid mental health care workers, social workers, and resource officers in our school. Second of all, I am in favor of having locks and glass-proof windows on every door in the school so that if a shooter gets in the school, people have a chance to keep away from them. I also am very much strongly in favor of a nationalized healthcare system where we treat mental illness, recognize mental illness as a medical disease, and try to step in with patients before something like this happens. On the other hand, I know as a physician how hard it is to recognize when a patient is significantly mentally ill. That, because of that, I think we have to make efforts to limit gun access in this society. And I know we have a Second Amendment, I know people have the right to own guns, but as a society, we have a right to know that we're safe. So things like banning assault weapons, they should not be for sale in our sporting goods stores. Licensing and registering people so that if we know you have a serious mental illness or you've been convicted of domestic abuse, we know you have a gun and we know how to get it away from you. There are some very simple, common sense things that we can do to control access of guns to mentally ill patients or simply socially ill patients without infringing on people's rights to own guns.